Father John po, STB, we are now in the second Sunday of Lent. Lenten season for us is a season of renewal. And we all know, for us to be able to renew ourselves, we must be able to find the courage and the will to change the things that we have to change in our life. And that is, I think, the message of our celebration for today, in the second Sunday of Lent. To find the courage and the strength to face the challenges of life. Do not be afraid, because we have a companion, and the one who is commanding us to go away from our comfort zone and for us to grow as a person is the Lord. In our first reading, God tested Abraham to offer his only son before the Lord. And Abraham, even though he is so afraid, hurting, he followed because he knows that the one who is commanding him to do these things is the Lord. And because he followed and faced his fear, he was able to overcome the limitation of his heart. He was able to prove his love and his faithfulness to God. And because of that, he was blessed by the Lord. No, he was blessed so abundantly that until now we remembered him because of that. And in our gospel for today, taken from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 9, verse 2 to 10, the transfiguration of the Lord before the eyes of Peter, James, and John. Nakita nila kasama ni Jesus si Moses and Elijah. Elijah is the greatest prophet, and the work of the prophet is to bring the words, the message of the Lord. And tung si Jesus ngayon is the Word became flesh, who is promised to bring salvation. And Moses was the sign of the covenant of God. And now Jesus is the new covenant that will bring peace, will bring freedom, and will bring the renewal of the world. Kung kaya nga po, naging malinaw kung sino si Jesus. And there and then, the Lord was able to say to Peter, James, and John, who were so terrified, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid to face the challenges that you're going to face because of your faith. We have to journey. We have to go back and face all these challenges without fear, because it is very clear to you now kung sino yung kasama ninyo sa paglalakbay. So in this season of Lent, we are being reminded, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid to face the challenges na hinihingi sa atin for us to be able to renew ourselves. Maybe the challenge of the Lord is learn how to forgive. It is the Lord commanding you to forgive. And it is the Lord who will journey with you for you to be able to forgive. Just don't be afraid. Listen to this message. Listening. Listen because the Lord is the one commanding us. And I think this is the message of the second Sunday of Lent. We will not be afraid because our Salmong Tugunan is proclaiming something before us. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. Psalm 116 is telling us, we are not walking alone. Choose to walk with the Lord for you to be able to fulfill the changes that you want to happen into your life. If the Lord is challenging you to forgive, do not be afraid to forgive. He will give you all the strength as long as you journey with Him. If you're facing so many trials, problems, challenges in your life, the Lord is telling you, do not be afraid. Because I will be journeying with you, your God. So in this second Sunday of Lent, let us recall to our minds, ano yung mga kinakatakutan natin gawin for us to become a better person? To forgive, to let go all these past things that holds us back to become a better person? Let go. As in our gospel will tell us, this is my beloved Son. Listen to Him. And the Lord is telling us, let go of it. Because I am your God, walking with you, giving you all the strength and the support that you need for you to become a better person. So once again, my dear friends, in this Lenten season, a time of renewal, let us renew ourselves with the Lord. So once again, my dear friends, God bless us all.